Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just wanna lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone, so leave a message at the tone. Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything. I'm gonna kick my feet up and stare at the fan. Turn the TV on, throw my hand in my pants. Nobody's gonna tell me I can't. Nah, I'll be lounging on the couch, just chilling in my snuggie. Click to MTV so they can teach me how to Dougie. Cause in my castle, I'm the...
Documentary movie, we make a trip to the Jakarta Old Town to the Wayang Puppet Museum. Kota Tua Jakarta, or in English, Jakarta Old Town, is a small area in the northern Jakarta, which was in the Dutch colonial era, was simply the downtown of Batavia, or its called Jakarta. There are some ways of transportation if you want to go to the Jakarta Old Town. For example, if you want to take buses, take Trans Jakarta bus and stop at the Kota Shelter on the corridor 1 of the Trans Jakarta busway. If you like to take train, you can take Jakarta Commuter Train or KRL Jabodetabek and stop at the Jakarta Kota Train Station. But if you don't like to take any public transportation, of course you could use your own vehicle or cars, like we did when we were making this documentary. But be careful, because this is Jakarta, if you take the wrong time, you could stuck in a traffic jam for many hours, like us when we're making this documentary.
Was handed to the Ministry of Education, and 1968, this building was handed to the government of Jakarta. And finally, in 1975, this building was turned into the Wayang Museum as it now by the governor of Jakarta at that time, Mr. Ali Sadikin.
Yes, that's right. In fact, this building is not the original building at all. The original building was destroyed in 1808 by a large earthquake. And on the same spot, the same building was made for a museum. The next area we are entering is the Wayang Golek area. Wayang Golek is a wayang puppet which is made from a wood. And Wayang Golek is very popular, especially among the Sunda people.
The first area we are entering is the Wayang Golek area. This is an example of Wayang Golek. Raden Bima. Raden Bima was a great knight, and he had a powerful and he had nail called Pukul Pandawa, which was very powerful. He was second son of Prabu Pandewanata and Dewi Kunti. He was one of five Pandawa. Thank you.
Selamat malam adikku. Malam diselamatkan. Good night. Apaan itu good night? Wah, wow, kamu kurang gaul bahasa Inggris tuh. Aku cinta kamu. Ini gimana nih rencana kita buat bikin grup band nih? Iya dong. Kita jangan kalah sama pasak ungu. Iya, gua kan pasak merah, lihat tuh. Emang Kang Cepot bisa main alat musik apa aja? Wah, wow, jangan ditanya. Gitar? Wah, wow, jangan ditanya. Drum? Jangan ditanya. Suling? Jangan ditanya. Keyboard? Jangan ditanya. Kenapa jangan ditanya? Kagak ada yang bisa itu mah. Panggil saya penyanyi dari luar negeri. John Letoy. John Lennon. Iya, iya. Baiklah, kita tampilkan malam ini John Lennon. Udah tepuk tangan semua. Lagunya gak ada yang hafal. Memalukan. Oke, don't let me down. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Nobody ever loves Sida Siduki. Siduki, yes, yes, Siduki. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. juga ngedukung. Udah, sorry. Gua enggak mau, enggak batal punya grup band. Kapok, don't let me down. Don't pergi gua.
This room, or it's more likely to be called a small part, contain many inscriptions from the Dutch colonial era. This is called the Wayang Revolusi Room because the wayang in this room depict story of Indonesian struggle against colonialism. But because this room was under renovation, there was hardly any light inside this room, so we decided to leave.
Now, here in area, both the gamelan area and the collection of Yai Intan Papel. This is gamelan. Gamelan is made by bronze, iron, and wood. Gamelan is used for a puppet show.
Wayang kulit is popular especially among the Japanese and the Balinese people. And this is the example of few wayang kulit there are within the wayang kulit area in the wayang museum.
Okay, now we entering the wayang kulit area. I will show you some of it. Wayang kulit from Beruang Abean, LG 2LB. Oke.
Okay. This is wayang kulit from Purwakarta. This is Lumba Lembu Sura. Was a party or government, a governor from Gua Kisenda under the government of Prabu Mahesasura. Lembu Sura was a giant with buffalo head. Lembu Sura was killed by Narapati Sugriwa and Prabu Mahesasura. Prabu Mahesasura at Gua Kisenda because he wanted Dewi Tara as his wife.
Okay, this one wayang kulit from Surakarta. Okay, this one called Rahwana. He's son of Bengawan Wisrawa and Dewi Sukasi. He has three brother and he is the one who become king of Alengan Raja. Alengan Raja was selfish, egocentric, and betrayed.
Okay, this one was wayang kulit called Raden Lasmana.
night who didn't marry and stayed in Satrian Giri Tuba. He was polite, fearless, and very fine.
And that is Wayang Kulit Purwa from Surakarta. The name is Prabhu Ramawijaya. Ramawijaya was a son of Prabhu Dasaratha and Dewi Ragu. He was king of Ayodhya Pala and an incarnation of Bhadra Vishnu. His wife was Dewi Sinta. In Ramayana, he was famous. He had weapon called Bhuwijaya. He was wise, polite, and had power to oppress his brother, Raden Bharata, which is known as Hastabharata.
Also from Surakarta, Wayang Kulit Purwa Surakarta. This one is Manik Maya, Batara Guru. Batara Guru was a character who had the highest power in wayang. He ruled three worlds: God world, mystical world, and mortal world. He was son of Sanyang Tunggal and Dewi Wirandi. He had two siblings, Togok or Teja Maya, and Semar is all Ismaya. Batara Guru stay in Jogring, Saloka, and even though he was king, his sibling had tried to advise him.
Thank you.
Rashendal. The Rashendal was made of jeans, gypsum, wood, and coal. The tell story about Russian people, the girl was met in 2001 and become Museum Wayang collection in 2009. Polando. Boy and girl puppets with strip dress from Louis Centerfold.
For now, our documentary ends here. Thank you and goodbye.